children and that Elosiah, allow your head from your glory from the heavens to fall and cover the children and that Elosiah. And we praise you and we bless you and that Elosiah. Thank you, Father, for delivering every man under the sound of my voice, every father, Lord, every uncle, every grandfather, Osham and that Elosiah. You're more than able and that Elosiah. Give him another chance, Oshaba. I beg, and that Elosiah, another chance be allotted unto him, and that Elosiah, that they would cry out, what must I do to be saved? And that Elosiah, where they're wrong, they're turning to right, and that Elosiah, where they're lifted, they're being brought down, Oshaba. And that Elosiah, and I give thy name glory and praise, and that Elosiah, I lift every woman up, and that Elosiah, I lift them up, and that Elosiah, I lift the wife up, Oshaba. Those that have been hurt under the Osiah, those that are being abused under the Osiah and misused under the Osiah, I plead the blood, the blood, the blood prevail under the Osiah. You're turning around, Oshaba, the Osiah. You're turning around, Oshaba, under the Osiah. You're turning the right side up under the Osiah. That which was turned upside down is turning right side up, and they find favor with you and man under the Osiah. It gets better for them today under the Osiah. I break every stronghold in their life in the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, the Holy One. He come down and say on the Osiah, Oshaman down and see on the Osiah. Holy Ghost, have your way over the women under the Osiah. Shaman down and Osiah, that they would be moved to pureness under the Osiah, holiness and righteousness under the Osiah. That they would no longer compromise under the Osiah. That they would no longer walk in a disguise under the Osiah. But they would be they will be content the way you made them, Ashaba. Oh, glory under the Osiah. Glory, Shabanosia. Hallelujah. Under the Osiah. Oh, glory under the Osiah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oshaba. Yes, Lord. Ashaman da Osiah. He come da da say on the Osiah. Thank you, Ashaman da da Osiah. Yes, Lord. Oshaba. Yes, Lord. And da da see the Osiah, and I give thy name glory, honor, and praise. And I give thy name glory, honor, and praise. It's unto you, Lord, I lift you, and I give thy name glory, honor, and praise. Oshaba. And I thank you. I'm the Osiah. I pray every word under in the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Holy One. Holy Ghost, have your way over this airway. Oh, Father, we need to hear from you. I pray every word in the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Holy One. But, Father, if you will speak to us from this place, I feel that presence and I thank you. Oh, speak to us, Osiah. Release and that Elosiah and the Elosiah, Shaman, that Elosata, hey, Yabasana, the Elosiah, hey, Shaman, the Diosa, yea, Yamanda, the Elosiah, Shaman, the Elosiah, hey, speak, Yamanda, the Elosiah, release and the Elosiah, heal, Shaman, the Diosiah, and we praise you, Shaba, and we clap our hands to you, we clap our hands to you, we bless you, we clap our hands to you. We clap those hands and give him glory, honor, and praise. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, wherever you are, worship him. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. He's turning everyone under the sound of my voice to a conqueror. And he's turned you into a conqueror to go conquer. Oshaba. Osiah. Praise him. All ye people of Zion. Praise the Lord. I'm not an Osiah. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. All ye that have breath, praise the Lord. Oshaba. Osiah. And we give him glory, honor, and praise. And we thank him. And we say, hey, Shabbat, not an Osiah. Oh, worship him. Worship him, worship him, worship him, worship him, worship him. And the true worshipers will still be worshiping him. Lift those hands up and worship him. Open up your mouth and give him glory, honor, and praise. Tell him thank you, Oshaba. Clap those hands, all ye people, and make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. For truly the Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. I pray every word in the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, the Holy One. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, O Shaban. We give him glory. We give him praise. Amen. Glory is Shaman. Glory is Shaba. Oh, glory is Shaman. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. 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 Truly, this is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it. I'm excited for another broadcast. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. I'm going to say it again. And I choose to rejoice and be glad in it. The name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous runneth in, and they are safe. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. My heart shall make a boast unto the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, won't you magnify the Lord with me? Let us exalt his name together. Truly, the Lord is good. Amen. A stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knoweth them that trusteth in him. And we honor the Lord today for what he's done. Amen. And I'm excited to be before you one more time, just one more time, to fellowship in this space, in this realm, and in this place, that Jehovah would be glorified, that he would be glorified in us and through us. Hallelujah. So I'm excited about that. And I pray that you are as well, excited about what God is doing in this day concerning you, concerning you, concerning you. Amen. I may not be that long today, but very pointed. I was sitting down and the Lord said, tell my people I'm moving them into becoming a conqueror. To conquer. And there are many of you under the sound of my voice that have been in battles, amen, or preparing for battles or fights, huh? And you need to be able to understand that you are a conqueror. And you want to know how to conquer this thing that is in front of you. Well, the Lord is going to give us some instructions, because God said today that you are a conqueror. I spoke directly to Jehovah, and he said that you are more than a conqueror. And I'm making you a conqueror to conquer, Oshava. And so I'm going to read with you real quick out of the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 11, starting at verse 8. Therefore, you are to keep every mitzvah I am giving you today, so that you will be strong enough to go in and take possession of the land you are crossing over to conquer, crossing over to conquer the land, and so that you will live long in the land Adonai swore to give your ancestors and their descendants, and a land flowing with milk and honey. For the land you are entering in order to take possession of, it isn't like the land of Egypt. There you would sow your seed and had to use your feet to operate its irrigation system as in a vegetable garden. But the land you are crossing over to take possession of is a land, hills and valleys, which soak up water when rain falls from the sky. It is a land Adonai your God cares for. The eyes of Adonai your God are always on it, from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. So if you listen carefully to keep my mitzvahs, which I am giving you today, to love Adonai your God and serve him with all your heart and all your being, then, says Adonai, I will give your land its rain at the right season, including the early fall rains at the late spring rains, so that you can gather in your wheat, new wine, and new olive oil. And I will give your fields grass for your livestock, with the results that you will eat and be satisfied. But be careful not to let yourselves be seduced so that you turn aside serving other gods and worshiping them. Yehovah, excuse me, is turning a lot of you under the sound of my voice into becoming conquerors. And the conquerors are going in to conquer. And this is not like the things that you were battling with before. God is bringing you into a new thing where all the substance and things were being prepared. Amen. This thing that God is about to allow you to conquer is going to allow you to move into a realm or space, amen, where his eyes is on, where he takes care of it, amen. And the only requirement is that you love him with all your heart, body, soul, and spirit, huh? And that you don't go to serving other guys, that you don't go to serving TVs, cars, a man, a woman, huh? A job, a pastor, a bishop, apostle, huh? You don't go making false idols and idol gods, huh? Because then it will turn up and become a curse. So, but if you will allow yourself to obey all the laws and the characters of God, God is taking you to a place where you don't have to do as you have had to do. See, when they were over in Egypt, they had to work the ground, huh? But God is saying, look, you're not going to have to work this ground. I've already done the footwork for you. So Jehovah's taking you to a place where he's already done the footwork. This could go even for some of you that may have come out of a bad relationship and you're trying to conquer this thing and you want to go into another relationship. But then so it's not going to be as difficult because God's eye is on this. Jehovah's eye is on this. And Jehovah has made a way. Now, I'm not sitting up here talking about no dating and all that stuff. No, I'm just talking principles. Whatever your situation is that you need to conquer, whatever it is that he promised you, huh? That he promised you, I'm telling you, about to walk in it. And the only thing that you need to do is be careful to keep all his precepts and his promises. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And that's what Jehovah is saying today. He said, son, tell them I'm turning the people from being a I'm moving them into being a conqueror to go and conquer. And so wherever you are, just know and repeat it after me. I'm a conqueror and I've been made to conquer. Jehovah told me I'm a conqueror. Put your name in it. Zari, I am Zari, a conqueror. And I've been made to conquer. Huh? That's right. He's made me a conqueror to go in and conquer. Glory be to God. In the book of Psalms 44, verses 4 and 5, because you favored them, command complete victory for Jehovah. Because you have favored them. And there's some of you under the sound of my voice, you don't know why everything always turns out the way it is. I'm telling you right now, you're going to experience favor like you never experienced it before. I've always, even in my early years, I've always had God's favor. And look, what nothing that I did, because I did more wrong than I did good. And that's just me testifying to myself, huh? And, you know, the meek shall inherit the earth. And I know I don't deserve the favor of God, but he gives it to me in spite of the way I've acted and the things I've done, huh? And there may be somebody out there that may be experiencing that. You know that the things that you're walking into and the things that God is doing for you at this time, you know you don't deserve it. And you know you're in awe based on what you came out of or what you used to do. Hallelujah. I was talking to a good friend of mine the other day. Amen. And he's a tractor trailer driver. And the young man said to me, he said, man, I'm just so grateful, man, because, man, listen, I know I don't deserve none of this stuff. He said, Zari, I was wilding. He said, man, I was just doing my thing. He said, but, and you know, everything just turns around and, you know, I got favor now. I got favor. And you can move to a place where you have favor with God and man. Now, listen, but the thing about it is I begin to tell him, I said, yeah, man, I said, that's good, brother, because, you know, the word teaches us that the meek shall inherit the earth. You got a lot of people that are hiding behind their past, huh? And that won't last, huh? And you wouldn't think they never did anything wrong, huh? And but, you know, let me tell you something. You testified, you know, and they overcame him by what? The word of their testimonies, huh? I testify about how Yehovah brought me out. Hallelujah. Listen, if he didn't have to bring me out, there would have been no need for Yeshua the Messiah to come, huh? If I could have did it all on my own, or I was already done. But thank be it unto Yehovah that he sent